train there.
They put it half above ground. That's it. And so it was only the white people that didn't know about this. They started spreading the word. They started doing some amateur, instead of about 18 years, where people were coming in here. This was an ancient culture they knew nothing about, but it needed to be protected. And they were connected by a common wall. The ruin blocks were maybe 6 by 8. You have more feed than it ever gone, and then the sunlight could get through and grow. There's two over there and a couple ago.
Everyone get a picture?
Yeah. See, I'm right even with that buck. He's looking right at us right now. I'll say this. There are about 600 cliff dwellings in the bounds of this 53,000 acres. And that more closely represents the average size of a cliff dwelling across the Colorado Plateau than do these others like Spruce Tree House and Longhouse and all the others, Cliff Palace. All these canyons were formed by erosion and uplifting. Okay? Now that top layer of sandstone at one time was the ocean bed of the last invasion of a sea in this area. And that invasion came from two directions and covered two-thirds of North America. It came from the Gulf of Mexico, and it came from the Washington, Oregon area, and invaded this area about 100 million years ago. It was here for 30 million years, which is quite amazing. Now, that would have been the last invasion of the Triassic area. And if you were able to peel away the talus slope there, you would see two more sandstone formations that represent the first two invasions of an ocean over 200 million years ago. So, pretty amazing what geologists can figure out. You're going to be standing right where the Wendells and his crew were when they...
The basket makers were hunters and gatherers, but they were also farmers, cultivating corn and squash.